Very good evening. Welcome to 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfet. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa today patronized the Commemoration Day ceremony in the presence of His Royal Highness, the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. Upon His Majesty's arrival, he was received by the Chief of the National Guard, Lieutenant General Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa Al Khalifa, and the Minister of Interior, Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa.
سلام سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة ملك البلاد المفدى. سلام. قف. كتفان سلاح جنبان سلاح طابور أسرع.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين. ولا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. صدق الله العظيم.
After recitation verses from the Holy Quran, a shot was fired marking a minute of silence.
طلقة لإعلان دقيقة صمت وأرى الجميع هنا واقفين وسوف تنتهي دقيقة الصمت مع الطلقة الأخرى ويتبعها عزف لحن الرجوع الأخير.
طمور أسره.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى
the head of the Sharia court at the Cassation Court, Sheikh Adnan Al-Qattan, delivered a speech and prayer for the martyrs. Sheikh Adnan then recited verses from the Holy Quran and Hadith by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. After thanking God, Sheikh Adnan expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa for assigning 17 December as a day of commemoration in recognition of the sacrifices of the martyrs from the BDF, the Ministry of Interior and the National Guard for responding to the call of duty and for defending the country. Sheikh Adnan prayed for the martyrs, asking the Almighty God to rest their soul in eternal peace and place them in heaven. He also asked the Almighty God to save guard the kingdom of Bahrain and save and protect His Majesty the King, offering him abundant health.
فيقول ما أسأل وأتمنى إلا أن تردني إلى الدنيا فأقتل في سبيلك 10 مرات لما رأى من فضل الشهادة. وبعد بعد شكر الله تعالى نتقدم بالشكر والتقدير والامتنان لصاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله وأيده، الذي خصص هذا اليوم 17 من شهر ديسمبر من كل عام يوما للشهيد، تخليدا ووفاء وعرفانا بتضحيات وعطاء وبذل شهداء الوطن من منتسب قوة دفاع البحرين ووزارة الداخلية والحرس الوطني الذين ضحوا بأرواحهم من أجل الواجب الوطني المقدس ووهبوا أنفسهم لتظل راية مملكة البحرين والجزيرة العربية خفاقة عالية، حيث كتب الله لهم الشهادة وهم يؤدون مهامهم وواجباتهم الوطنية مع إخوانهم المناضلين داخل الوطن وخارجه في جميع الميادين المدنية والعسكرية والإنسانية. فتحية إجلال وإكرام ملؤها المحبة والافتخار والكرامة والاعتزاز لكل شهدائنا الأبطال عبر تاريخ وطننا الغالي البحرين الحافل بالتضحيات قديماً وحديثاً، الذين قدموا أرواحهم دفاعاً عن دينهم ووطنهم وذوداً عن شرفهم وحقوقهم وشرعيتهم. وفي هذه المناسبة الجليلة نرفع أكف الضراعة إلى المولى العلي القدير داعينا لشهدائنا الأبرار ماضياً وحاضراً في مملكتنا الغالية البحرين وفي دول مجلس التعاون الخليجي وفي التحالف العربي، ولكل شهيد ندعو لهم بالرحمة والمغفرة ودخول الجنان ونقول: اللهم يا قاضي الحاجات ويا مجيب الدعوات ويا رب الأرض والسماوات، نسألك اللهم بأن تتقبل شهداءنا الأبرار وتدخلهم الجنة مع عبادك المقربين. آمين. اللهم أنزلهم منزلا مباركا وأنت خير المنزلين. آمين. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم. آمين. وأكرم نزلهم ووسع مدخلهم. آمين. واغسلهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. آمين. اللهم إن كانوا محسنين فزد في حسناتهم. آمين. وإن كانوا مسيئين فتجاوز عن سيئاتهم. آمين. اللهم املأ قبورهم بالرضا والنور والفسحة والسرور. آمين. والكرامة والحبور. آمين. اللهم اجعلهم في بطون القبور مطمئنين. آمين. وعند قيام الأشهاد آمنين وبجودك واثقين وإلى أعلى درجاتك سابقين. آمين. اللهم يمن كتابهم ويسر حسابهم وثقل بالحسنات ميزانهم. آمين. وثبت على الصراط أقدامهم. آمين. وأسكنهم في الجنة بجوار نبيك ومصطفاك محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. آمين. وارحمنا يا مولانا إذا صرنا إلى ما صاروا إليه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إن أبناءنا وإخواننا الشهداء قد مضوا إلى حالهم وسبقونا بأعمالهم، فاجعل مأواهم في أعلى عليين من الجنات. آمين. مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. آمين. اللهم قد ترك الشهداء أهلهم وودعوا أحبابهم وفارقوا ذويهم، اللهم فارحم جموع المحبين وحنين المشتاقين. اللهم واجمع بينهم وبين أهلهم في جنات النعيم. اللهم اربط على قلوب أمهات وآباء الشهداء وألهمهم الصبر والقوة والسلوان يا رب العالمين. اللهم آمنا في وطننا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمناً مطمئناً سخاءً رخاءً وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم وفق ولي أمرنا ملكنا حمد بن عيسى لما تحب وترضى. اللهم اجعله مفتاحاً للخير مغلاقاً للشر. اللهم احفظه من شر الأشرار وكيد الفجار. اللهم أعزه وأطل في عمره وأحسن عمله وألبسه ثوب الصحة والعافية. اللهم وفقه لما فيه الخير والصلاح للبلاد والعباد، وهيئ له البطانة الصالحة الناصحة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم اجمع به الكلمة ووحد به الصف، واجعله سبباً لحقن الدماء واجتماع القلوب. اللهم اجعله إماماً للتسامح والتعايش والتآخي والتحاب، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم من أرادنا وبلادنا البحرين وبلاد الحرمين الشريفين وخليجنا وجيشنا ورجال أمننا وأمتنا، من أرادنا بشر وسوء وفتنة فأشغله بنفسه، واجعل كيده في نحره، وأدر دائرة السوء عليه، وأرنا فيه عجائب قدرتك، وانصرنا على من عادانا وبغى علينا يا سميع الدعاء. اللهم إنا نستودعك وطننا وخليجنا وجنودنا البواسل المرابطين الذين يحاربون الآن عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم احفظهم براً وبحراً وجواً، وانصرهم على الطاغين الباغين المعتدين. اللهم سدد رميهم وثبت أقدامهم وأنزل سكينتك عليهم، وأعدهم إلى وطنهم وأهلهم سالمين غانمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الآن نقرأ سورة الفاتحة على أرواح شهدائنا الأبرار في الماضي والحاضر، ونسأل الله تعالى أن يجعل هذه الساعة ساعة إجابة وقبول.
Prayer was then performed for the souls of the martyrs.
الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
بعد ذلك مرت عدد من الطائرات المقاتلة من سلاح الجو الملكي البحريني F-16 تعبيرا عن الوفاء لشهداء الواجب.
Then His Majesty the King irrigated the palm tree that represents a symbol of life. The ceremony was concluded with playing the royal anthem. Then His Majesty the King greeted his senior officers and the audience. On such occasion, His Majesty the King gave a statement in which he expressed great satisfaction to patronize and attend the ceremony of Commemoration Day. His Majesty said that such a day is a national occasion which honors the kingdom martyrs, those faithful and courageous men of Bahrain who sacrificed their lives for their country and the nation by responding to the call of duty against enemies who threatened the sovereignty of the kingdom. His Majesty added that such sacrifices will always be remembered in Bahrain's national history. His Majesty went on to say that the 17th of December of every year is an occasion that will always be remembered in Bahrain's national march and will represent a source of pride in the sons of Bahrain who sacrificed their lives defending the righteousness and for extending a humanitarian and helping their brothers. His Majesty added that the kingdom is proud of every martyr and they are proud of their families because they sacrificed their lives so that Bahrain's flag remains high among countries of the world. His Majesty added that of no less status are the families of the martyrs, those parents who raised their children to love their country and sacrifice for it. A salute to the families of the martyrs, His Majesty added. His Majesty also voiced thanks and appreciation for the national stances which citizens has demonstrated in recognition of the martyrs, which reflect their unity and determination to respond to call of duty in order to defend the country without hesitation. His Majesty asked for mercy for the martyrs, asking for the Almighty God to rest their souls in eternal peace. Then His Royal Highness the Crown Prince proceeded to the Charter Edifice, where His Majesty greeted senior officers in commemoration of the Martyrs' Day. His Royal Highness the King highlighted the importance of the Martyrs' Day. For their part, the senior officers conveyed greetings to the leadership of the country, marking the Kingdom's Commemoration Day, which coincides with the creation of the modern state of Bahrain as an Arab Muslim country in the year 1783 during the reign of founder Ahmed al-Fatih, 45th anniversary since Bahrain joined the United Nations as a full member, and the 17th anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. They lauded His Majesty's keenness to patronize the commemoration ceremony and asked the Almighty God to safeguard Bahrain under its wise leadership.
Thank you. Bahrainis pay their respects today to the martyrs whose names and sacrifices to keep this nation stable, safe and prosperous will forever remain engraved in our history.
I would like to thank His Majesty Sheikh Hamad for him so that he dedicated a day for the martyrs, and I am so proud that my uncle gave his soul for this country, and I am too ready to give my soul for this country too.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa has dedicated the 17th of December of each year, which coincides with the anniversary of His Majesty's accession to the throne, to the martyrs of Bahrain. The day is a remembrance of all the soldiers and policemen who gave their lives to the kingdom's peace and security.
I just want to thank him for putting work and effort into making this day happen and making it an actual day. And I also would like to thank everybody for their recognition. We were all devastated, but it's nice to see that people are here with us and they're supporting us and they're, you know, giving us their hands. So I'm very thankful for that.
The commemoration day was launched last year as a token of gratitude to the brave servicemen of the BDF, Interior Ministry and National Guard.
So I'm proud of my husband. He has given his life. He lost his life for this kingdom of Bahrain. And may Allah accept martyrdom of all the martyrs and give the highest rank to all the martyrs in Jannah. Also, I want to say thanks to the government of Bahrain and His Majesty King.
The day comes to shed light on the sacrifices of these brave men and women and appreciate what they have given to our beloved kingdom. And today, Bahrain remembers its martyrs, those who have given their lives to the security and stability of this great nation and its people. Hamid Shaban, Bahrain International News.
Under the patronage of the Commander of the Royal Guard, Brigadier General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the Commander of the Royal Guard Special Force, His Highness Major Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, a ceremony was held today at the Royal Guard of Bahrain Defense Force to commemorate those who sacrificed their life for the sake of their nation on December the 17th, which coincides with the 17th anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. Following recitations from the Holy Quran, an official ceremony was held to mark Commemoration Day. His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad then watered a palm tree symbolizing eternal life. On the occasion, His Highness Sheikh Nasser saluted with pride and gratitude the sacrifices of servicemen who lost their lives while carrying out their honorable national duty of supporting justice. He also recalled Bahrain's patriots who, since the eras of His Majesty's forefathers, have sacrificed themselves in the line of duty to defend their religion and the homeland and in support of brotherly nations, saying that their bravery, courage and loyalty will always be remembered. His Highness Sheikh Nasser reiterated the pledge of loyalty to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Supreme Commander, and stressed that his wise leadership is a source of inspiration and resolve. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Olympic Committee and Honorary Chairman of Bahrain Royal Equestrian and Endurance Federation, the BREEF, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa and the First Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Athletics Association and Captain of the Al Khalidiyah Stables, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, have attended the National Day's Endurance Tournament. The race, which covered a distance of 120 kilometers, witnessed the participation of the Bahrain Royal Endurance Team and various local teams, as well as participants from the GCC, France and the United States of America. For this occasion, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad praised the success of the event due to the large participation and the outstanding results achieved by the riders. He asserted that their performance reflect the great development attained by Bahraini endurance teams. He expressed his optimism regarding the future of the sport of endurance, noting the emergence of many talents able to continue the march of this sport. He also asserted the royal team's continuous effort of discovering new talents and developing them in order to support the ranks of the team and rely on them in upcoming tournaments. His Highness congratulated the winners, expressing appreciation for the efforts of the president and members of the BREEF and the committees participating in the championship. He also highlighted their role in the success of the championship. His Highness noted that the participation of female riders and their competence for top places proved their high potential and their keenness on affirming their presence in the endurance sport, asserting his support for them in the upcoming races. The BREEF Administrative Board member and chairman of the Endurance Committee, Sheikh Naij bin Salman Al Khalifa, crowned the winners at the conclusion of the competition. And under the directives of His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad, Bahrain Defense Force affiliates participated in the National Day Endurance Race for the occasion of the Commemoration Day. His Highness Sheikh Nasser cited such participation as a gesture of tribute to the memory and honor of our martyrs who embodied courage and selflessness. His Highness the First Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Athletics Association, Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, stated that the Commemoration Day, which coincides with the creation of the modern state of Bahrain as an Arab Muslim country in the year 1783 during the reign of founder Ahmed al-Fatih, the 45th anniversary since Bahrain joined the United Nations as a full member, and the 17th anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne, is an important day that marks the martyrs' bravery in defending their land and their religion. His Highness added that the martyrs sacrificed their lives to preserve the unity of the land and its Arab and Islamic identity, which was reflected in the development of the kingdom based on the Islamic Sharia, justice and loyalty. Sheikh Khalid affirmed that the martyrs and their sacrifices will not be forgotten and that they will always be models of loyalty to the homeland for further generations. His Highness expressed pride in the martyrs, asserting that he was honored to have served with them in the battlefield. Bahrain Embassy in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia held a reception ceremony marking Bahrain's national days in the presence of His Royal Highness Riyadh Governor Prince Faisal bin Bandar bin Abdulaziz Al Saud. The ceremony was attended by members of the Saudi royal family, senior officials and invitees. Bahraini ambassador to Saudi Arabia Sheikh Hamoud bin Abdullah Al Khalifa welcomed His Royal Highness Prince Faisal and the attendees on arrival to take part in Bahrain's celebrations of the national days marking the anniversary of the establishment of the modern state of Bahrain as an Arab and Muslim country in 1783 by its founder Ahmed al-Fatih, the 45th anniversary of its accession to the UN as a full member, and the 17th anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. His Royal Highness Prince Faisal extended congratulations to Bahrain's leadership on the national occasion, lauding the government's achievements and growth.